In this tutorial, you'll learn what an API is, connect a Thunkable project to a web API, retrieve and parse the relevant data from the response, and use Thunkable blocks to modify the API URL that is called. Let's start by answering the question, what is an API? API is the acronym for Application Programming Interface. It is software that acts as a link between two applications and allows them to talk to each other. APIs are everywhere. Using your phone to change the temperature on your home's thermostat, check the weather, or make a dinner reservation all rely on APIs. The APIs act as messengers. When you initiate an action in an app on your phone, the API delivers your request to a system and then retrieves a response to return to you. There are many publicly available APIs, some for free, others for a fee. Here's one example of a public API list that we found useful. Once you've identified the API you want to use, the next step is connecting your Thunkable project to it. We'll demonstrate the process using this free public weather API, so we'll copy the URL to use in a moment. Here we have a screen with the following components: a text input where the user can type in a city name, a button to trigger the communication with the API, identifier labels, static text labels used to identify the content that will populate the associated fields, and output labels that act as placeholders. The text within these label components will populate based on the data retrieved from the connected API. On the Blocks tab of your project, scroll down to the Advanced Blocks section and click the plus icon next to Web APIs. In the provided window, paste the URL for your API. For the purposes of testing, we'll delete the city in brackets and replace it with the name of a city. Best practice is to rename your Web API component. This is especially important if you connect multiple APIs to the same project. You can choose to enter query parameters, body, and headers here, but all of these values can also be updated using blocks. Click Submit. The web API we just added is nested here. Click Web API Weather to access the blocks associated with that API connection. The purple blocks represent the most common HTTP methods for retrieving and sending data. The GET method retrieves data from the server. This is the method that we'll demonstrate in this video. The POST method sends data to the server and creates a new data entry. The put method is used to update an existing data entry. The patch method is very similar to the put method because it also modifies an existing resource. But for the patch method, the request is only the specific changes to the resource. The delete method is used to delete a data entry from the server. Now let's get to retrieving some data. Click the button's name in the component tree in the upper left and drag the When Button Click block into your workspace. Click Web API Weather and drag the Call Web API Weather Get block and nest it within the button block. This block has three outputs: response, status, and error. Response is the data that is returned from the API if the call is successful. Status is the HTTP status code which indicates whether the request has been successfully completed. And error contains the error if the API call is unsuccessful. Click to access the control blocks and drag the if, do, else block and drop it within the web API block. We'll start by telling the app what to do if there is an error. Drag the light green error block and attach it to the if statement. If the request results in an error, we'll indicate that in the description output label. So click the label in the component tree and drag the set label descriptions text to block and drop it next to the do in the if, do, else block. Use keyboard shortcuts to copy and paste the block. Drag and drop it next to else. Drag the error block to replace the light pink label text in the do space, and the response block to replace the label text in the else space. Let's test what we've built so far. Click the web preview button. Click the button on your app screen. Looks like our API connection worked. Nice. But this isn't how we want to present the content to our users. We need to pull out the relevant data from this JSON response. Seems this API refers to those properties as temperature and description. Okay, click back to editing. Click Objects, drag the Get Property of Object block and connect it to the Label Descriptions text block in the else space. Now to convert the JSON response to an object using the Get Object from JSON block. This will allow us to get the values we want and display them in our project. The value we want to display in the description label is the content of the API's description property. So within the quotes after get property, type description. This block combination tells the app to set the description label's text to the description property of the object's JSON response. Let's test it again. We expect the description field to populate with the current weather description for Vancouver. Excellent. Okay, let's replicate the process for the temperature. Use keyboard shortcuts to copy and paste the set label descriptions text to block and place it immediately under the original block. Use the drop-down menu to change the label's name and change the property name from description to temperature. Let's test it again. Great. But if you recall, the API is currently hard-coded to get the data for Vancouver. We need to add the functionality to get the weather data for the user's requested city. Click the gear icon next to Web API Weather, and in the URL field, delete the hard-coded city name and curly brackets. Click Submit. Now we aren't telling the API which city we'd like to get data for. Click Web API Weather and drag Set Web API Weather's URL to block and drop it above the purple Call API Get block. We need to add the city name to the end of the API's URL. Click Text, drag the Join block, and connect it to the block you just added. Delete the Hello and World blocks. The first part of the string goes at the top. So click Web API Weather again and drag the Web API Weather's URL block and drop it in the first space. Click the city's text input in the component tree and drag the text input city's text block and drop it in the remaining space. This block combination will add the user's input city to the end of the API's URL. Let's test it out once again, but this time input a city name in the text input component. Woohoo! Thanks for tuning in for how to connect your Thunkable app to a web API. Be sure to check out our other tutorials and Thunkable Academy courses. And remember, if you can think it, you can thunk it.